Give them a big shout out and say thank you for, you know, just being saints of God and loving and forgiving and showing other people how to react.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
Also, don't forget, y'all, that our next big giveaway galore number 3. Okay?
Come on.
Number,
come on.
Look, don't nobody think I'm throwing them no Illuminati sign because I just do 3 like this. Okay, 3.
This might be 3
times
number 2.
Okay, I don't know, but I ain't down with the Illuminati. So don't try to be like, oh, she throwing up the Illuminati. That ain't it. I put up 3 fingers and God gave me 5. I put down 2 and it equal 3. Right, no, I'm not down.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, so our next giveaway galore, which will be our holiday special giveaway. Now, I mean, we say holiday because y'all know we always do giveaways on holidays.
Amen.
But we are incorporating Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's all in one show.
Yes.
But she is a black Indian.
Okay.
See,
they're gonna breathe.
You gotta get fired
one day.
Breathe. We're gonna be famous,
and he ain't gonna be able to be in the audience.
Okay, yes, we're gonna make sure they have him in the back, in the green room somewhere,
in the booth, in the back, in the corner,
in the soundproof room.
That part. But whatever the case is, y'all. So our next big giveaway, the Lord marks on your calendars, Sunday, November 22nd, our 30th episode. It'll be our holiday galore giveaway, and I'm telling y'all, it's gonna be awesome. We got some great prizes for y'all. If y'all want to be included in the big prizes, which I mean, I'm gonna tell y'all like this: we're not the type of people that's gonna play y'all on the holiday. So we got multiple big prizes. We only got like one TV. You know what I'm saying?
I have to stop her.
It was getting crazy.
I'm saying,
but what I'm saying is that we ain't just got one big thing. We got a lot of big things. You know what I'm saying? So all you gotta do is donate $10.
Or a lot of good gifts. Because if we give y'all good gifts on a regular Smack Day, I mean, what kind of gifts y'all think we got for the holiday?
The holiday!
Come on!
And y'all know we acting crazy and we might get shut down again. So we were trying to make sure everybody can enjoy their home, okay? Yeah. So when I tell y'all we got some good gifts, make sure y'all donate $10 to the Smack Show. That's $ Smack Show. What's up, Vincent?
When is the cutoff day?
Now listen, the cutoff day is Sunday, November the 15th. That's the last day. I think that's the whole. Let me make sure. I want to make sure I'm giving y'all the right
day. Everybody make notation of cutoff day, please.
Yeah.
Now, if you know that effort, I'm assuming you're giving it to me.
November 15th is the cutoff day to donate because for the giveaway galore to be entered, because we have so many people donating that we want to make sure everybody's name get in the bucket.
Amen.
And that we got all the prizes already set and all that. We don't have time to try to do this last minute like we did before. So, $10 to $SmackShow. $SmackShow. Give $10 in the memo, put holiday giveaway, so we'll know to enter your name into the drawing for that.
Yes.
Other than that, if you don't give, it's okay. It's okay. You don't have to give. We still got gifts for the regular people who just support us on a regular basis. So, y'all still got time.
Yes.
Go ahead and get that $10 up. You can save $1 a day. I'm just saying.
$10, not $5 for long, but $10 for long.
Did I hear the door shut?
No, I'm not.
Anyway,
November the what? If the cutoff day, say it again.
November 15th. So Sunday, November 15th. That's
Make notation, everybody, please. Cutoff day. Thank you, Breezy. November the 15th.
Yeah,
if you get after the 15th, it's going to be mine.
It's gonna be considered a regular donation. Hey, we appreciate it. Ernie, we love you.
Ernie, you thought I was worth saving.
Oh my goodness.
Every time.
Okay. I'm tired of being Ernie. So you gave up that game, keep me Ernie. Okay. Ernie's gonna come here. Ernie, we need you to go on a show so you can sing that for my one day.
Yes.
Naya, we love you, Bunky.
That's my grandbaby, too.
Y'all,
I'm right here, tight.
So anyway, y'all, it's time. Y'all know what?
It's time to make a change.
Yo, okay, so did y'all see the debate?
Why are you sitting over clapping?
Cause y'all, I can't because y'all did it too fast. I didn't tell me I was gonna do it.
You gotta be paying attention.
Mom, I mean, it's like.
I do what I wanna do.
We've been doing the same thing every single time.
Well, that's okay. I do what I wanna do. But smack, smack, everybody, smack.
It's almost like when you sing and you're getting ready to do an ad-lib, your people that sing with you, like, you're like, you know I'm getting ready to start over, right?
Whatever.
You be like, it's time to talk. She be like,
talk about what?
Right.
Stop. Okay, come on, girl.
Anyway, so y'all know the debate came on, right? Hey, Tiana, girl.
Hi, Tiana.
And even her friend did too many.
Yeah, that's right.
She did four. She did four.
Tiana,
smacks.
It's three
smacks.
No, Tiana.
Thank you, said chill
no,
on me.
No, GG
right.
Friend.
Right.
Listen.
Right, everybody leave me alone.
Okay, anyway. All right. So, do y'all like our cotton candy color today?
Wait, Naya says time to get smacked.
That's
right, my grandma.
Mama's being real chaotic today, y'all. So it must be the cotton candy costumes we got on.
Uh-huh. Oh, we got costumes.
We got cotton candy costumes.
You know, you go to a celebration and they give you the cotton candy, it be pink. It be enough color.
Blue.
I like the pink.
Okay.
it. Come on.
I don't like it at all. Sugar is gross.
Yo, mom. I don't know what mom on ya.
She must have took her medicine.
I gotta check to see if she took her medicine, yo. Cause I, yo, you
hurt. I need to count them and see how many she took.
She turned up today. Anyway, so check it. The debate came on last week, and if y'all didn't watch it, it's okay. That's how y'all got us. You know what I'm saying?
We're here for.
We're here to tell y'all our version of the debate, okay?
Yes, okay, well, first of all, let me say this. Mm. Come on. I was actually kind of bored. It was really kind of boring.
You like drama.
You was bored?
You like drama.
I thought it was a little boring to me.
Okay.
No, I like
drama. Tell me why.
When you give me knowledge, I don't like drama. I like knowledge. I like to create drama.
I don't care about the savings. Come on, sis.
But I think, you know, thank you. Who that? Is that my mama? Thank you, mama. Yeah. Thank you, mama.
I am beautiful. Thank you, mama.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Just because somebody said cute, they always mean it's for you and Vera.
I'm just saying thank you for all of us.
And I'm cute, too. Sure. Just because I got on the wig. Come on.
Right.
I said my wig up.
And speaking of wigs, y'all, I am wearing a wig today because I didn't get this in my hair. So, yes. My sister let me borrow a wig.
She came
just in. Just make sure you leave your wig.
I got no straight black hair, and I just go sit up here. I had my hair wrapped up in the wimpy
suit. So, Vera,
I just said, very boring. They played the same.
Thank you,
Lord. They did. Listen.
Tried to get started on Ernie, and then
Ernie was good.
I think Biden was ready for him.
He came in ready.
He was overly ready, but you know, Biden usually stay ready anyway. Yeah. I just think that he wanted to make sure he didn't get too emotional if he talked about his family.
Yeah.
So that's why he was already like, I'm just gonna come ready so I can, you know,
stay ready. Ain't gotta get
exactly.
Ready.
He said something sideways, like whatever. I just thought, you know, they were gonna cut Trump's mic off, and then Trump was gonna go over there. Like,
they never cut his mic.
But he still was slick, though.
I just
need he was slick.
He really was.
He was. I wanted Biden to slap him one time.
No, but see, Biden's a G. He like Obama. He's a G. First of all, I don't have to tell y'all I'm a G. Just walk up on me and I'm going to show y'all I'm a G.
No.
You don't have to do all that.
No, sis. Cool, but hold on. So y'all know.
I'm like this. And then you walk up on me.
So y'all know that. So y'all know that Obama that came out, y'all, in the start, he done joined a campaign.
Yes.
He had got on after everything was, you know, right before the debate, you know, the day before, I think. And he was talking at the rally.
Yes, he was.
And he was talking about Trump. You know, they found out he had a secret Chinese bank account.
Oh, yeah.
And so, so Obama was like, so what happened was.
See,
okay.
I said he had bank account. That's what I'm sorry. Come on. I'm sorry.
Okay. I'm sorry. Sorry, y'all.
So. Obama was like, you know, his mom threw me off, y'all. Okay, so Obama was like, he had a secret Chinese bank account. And he was like, well, y'all can't be serious. He was like, if his favorite channel, basically, if Fox News found out that I had a Chinese bank, a secret Chinese bank account, he's like, come on, man. He was like, they be running around calling me Beijing Barry.
Yeah, that was a good one, honey. Yeah.
Y'all, they done found out so much junk about this dude, it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
To me, at this point, anybody voting for him, you really probably can't change their mind. It is what it is. They just like riding out for Trump.
They are.
Yeah. I don't even understand what's going on.
Honestly, the only way I really see that Trump's gonna win if he give people on unemployment like $800 extra to the channel. I'm telling you, people be going to
store. I would love to have Trump. That money, but I still
if he get $800 every 2 weeks, and if he get y'all stimulus check. He was talking about giving out $1,200 and $600 or $1,000 per child. Y'all, everybody vote for him.
I got the stimulus. I'm still not voting for him.
I won't vote for him because it won't do me no good. But I'm just saying, I still be true to my word. I won't vote for him.
I don't know. See, money don't move me like
and
that.
And that's why I won't vote for me because she's my friend.
Y'all involve her.
No, do not involve the audience. Okay. So whatever the case, y'all. Okay. Also, wait, real quick, I got some more news for y'all.
Okay,
so about our own personal, like the show news. Yeah. Hey Roslyn girl. But whatever the case is, so we smack people every Wednesday. We smack people.
Yes.
So for the winter months, we will be slowing down our smacking. We won't be smacking people like that. As far as like going and giving gifts to people. Like we might cash out some people, surprises, something like that. But our plan is to smack homeless shelters, women's centers, and nursing homes.
Yes.
So if you want to donate to that cause with us as far as like being a blessing to the nursing homes, the homeless centers, all that, we're going to be taking only new items. Yes. And we're going to be taking socks, like new socks,
blankets,
toothbrushes,
toothbrushes, and like hats and gloves and stuff like that.
And Fruit of the Loops.
Hey, whatever.
Undergarments.
Whatever y'all can donate, and you can donate.
We're still taking money.
I'm just letting y'all know that if y'all don't see too many smack pictures and videos on our thing starting after the 22nd, basically, that's why. Because we're going to be smacking bigger, we're going to be smacking corporations, basically, that help the homeless and stuff like that. You know, because old people always seem to be cold. They, a lot of them, you know, iron deficiencies and stuff like that. And then the homeless shelter definitely needs help. At all times. That's so we just want to give back. You know what I'm saying? That's and it's better to give back to people that really, really are in need, especially if at a time like this when they could be forgotten, easily forgotten. Hi, Anne. I love you.
But then a lot of people, too, don't have family members.
Or family coming to visit you. People that just come and visit them at home. So we're going to let them know that somebody cares. And I'm pretty sure people are doing this. I'm going to throw a little shout out there to Heather Taylor because she actually, they do stuff where they go dance in the nursing home.
Yeah.
I mean, when I seen that, the girls, they call it Worship Without Words.
Yes.
Their group is very anointed and blessed. I'm telling y'all, I seen some videos of them dancing there. They gonna come on the show one day. We're gonna try to figure some stuff out first. Yeah, make sure we got the set right. Can't bring people on and they ain't right.
The pandemic
gotta get under control first, and we gotta be able to have big enough space. So y'all just keep being a blessing to us so we can be a blessing to y'all, and you gotta work everything out.
Yeah.
And Faith, okay, she said count her in. That's what's up. We're gonna count you in, girl. Inbox us.
We love you guys.
Yes, we love y'all. So look, inbox us if y'all wanna help donate or whatever. We can tell y'all how to get the items to us or whatever.
And also, right. I mean, it ain't like y'all gotta spend tons of money because a lot of the stuff is at the dollar store.
Yeah.
So you don't have to spend tons of money to get this stuff here.
That part. Okay. So back to us talking next week.
Good job.
Anyway, so y'all know the kids, they're talking about the kids going back to school, right?
Uh-huh. Oh, come on now. That just makes
me mad. Hold on, though. This got to be tripping because they acting like the cases done rose so bad.
Yeah.
That it's like higher than it was before it even started.
Right.
Yeah, and everyone's so how are y'all talking about the kids going back to school in the fall? At the climax of everything that's going on. What do y'all think about that? What your kids going to be doing?
Oh, my kids staying home.
But I seen the thing for your kids specifically. I seen a little letter
What is your take on that, though?
I sent it to y'all so y'all could see what I had to go through that night.
You were real. So I want to know. You know what I'm saying?
No. Because I mean, I know they say you can send them back 2 days a week or 3 days a week. I mean.
Yeah, no. I don't care.
Yeah, they're not doing that.
Well, my husband works for the state of Michigan, and they most of them don't even go into the building. But even for the few of them that have been or that do, they still keep getting cases on and off. And that is baffling to me that they still keep getting cases with the few people that go into their building.
Yeah.
So I understand that they're saying that the children don't get it like that, but children are germ magnets, okay? They are cootie catchers.
They touch everything.
They hold the cooties.
They type on
the
walls.
They bring them home, and they give them to us.
Right.
And we can't handle it.
You can't handle the truth.
So it doesn't matter that the kids can handle the cooties. We can't handle the cooties.
That's why. So check this out, though. So back to talking smack, right? Yeah. So I was looking at some stuff on they were talking about these vaccines that they're getting ready to come out with, y'all. Hey, Crystal Brown, girl! Anyway, so they came out with these vaccines, and they said, you know, at first there was like over 30,000 people had signed up, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
But then they said over 100,000 people done signed up to do the vaccine trial.
Okay.
No, not me. Don't care.
Not about Trump.
But then they said they needed more black people and minorities basically to sign up.
I know why they
said
that.
But they said because, you know, if it's not enough of the black people signing up, they don't know if it's gonna work on them or not.
Right.
And I'm like, that's that part. Since we don't know, that's why we're not signing up. So
but see, this is why I can't see why they talk about the schools. Please don't get me wrong, people. I know for a fact that it may be hard for working parents to have their kids at home. And sometimes you get stressed out. You know, you be like, oh, I just need these kids out of my hair. But let me tell you something. Do you want them? Do you? I prefer to have my kids at home in my hair than be going down to Riley's funeral home. Or be going down to another funeral home and burying them. Or in the hospital where you can't come see them because.
You don't know where your kids are.
Don't take that for granted to say, oh, this kid will come out. I say, take it. No, take it.
Right.
Ask God to give to help you. Even if you're a long time, you know, my best time is at night when I'm by myself. You know, I love my husband and my daughter.
Shout out to our brother Charles. He out here. Hey, what's up, Toby?
That's to me, I feel like this. Don't put your kids out there in harm's way.
Right.
You know, because the day you decide you may take your kid, maybe the day your child brings something home.
Exactly. That's what you're trying.
You know, and you don't want to do that. It's not worth it, really. It's really not. You know, I think all this is it's a setup. Yeah. It's a setup to they feel like, well, if I cut this person, if I step here and do this, if I get these people bring their kids to church to school and stuff, why you think Trump is coming to Michigan to try. He coming to Michigan because number one, we know he don't like Big G.
Big Gretch.
He don't like her. But he's coming to also to really impose on the fact that we need to open. Well, we don't open up. They can't open up no more what they did.
Right. All right, what you going to do?
And then they stripped her of her rights, so she can't do nothing anyway.
I mean.
Hey, I still lie about some of them guys.
I think Deja Vu to open back up.
What? Not the Corona poll. I'm kidding.
Now who's sliding down the pole?
A Corona poll?
Like,
I bet not see nobody turn up in Deja Vu. Anyway, but look, but back to something serious.
Come on, y'all.
But back to these vaccines is what I'm saying. So they got a list of people, y'all, that they got like that's coming up with vaccines.
The Corona poll.
Y'all seen the commercials? Yeah. Strippers is like go to the poll, but. Wait, get your booty to the pole. I told you about that commercial that the strippers put out, y'all, didn't I? About get your booty to the pole. You said, what happened?
Is anybody else having trouble with their lives?
Yep. I see Birdie saying the lies is messed up.
Is anybody having problems right now? Can y'all hear us good? Because we seeing that people saying that the stuff is messed up.
Is everybody having freezing every now and then?
Okay.
I'm so sorry, you guys. You know, that's why we believe in God for a studio.
Well, I don't know if that has anything to do with us. It might be having something to do with outside.
Well, that's cool.
We can't do nothing. We sorry, y'all. We sorry for today's glitches. We don't got nothing to do with it. Hey, LaVell, girl. We love you, cuz. Anyway, so basically what I was saying. The vaccines, okay? Mm-hmm. So the vaccine, yo. Well, okay, they said they got like, what, 5 or 6 people that's making or creating a vaccine or whatever. Mm-hmm. Johnson & Johnson.
Mm-hmm. Not the cancer people.
Hold on, though. Johnson & Johnson is one of the people that's helping to create a vaccine.
Yes.
They're one of the companies that's trying to come up with something. Now, when I heard that on the news, I said, okay, you got to be kidding me. Not the Johnson & Johnson who got sued because their baby powder was making women get cancer.
Yes. Yeah.
The baby powder that they, you know, refreshed themselves with on a hot day was making them get cancer. Yes. And you want to come up with a vaccine? Yes. Oh, no, thank you.
Yes.
We don't want it. And I don't even understand how you let that happen. Also, I looked it up. I'm like, let me see what Johnson & Johnson is even talking about. And then to kind of find out, listen to this, y'all. So Johnson & Johnson, the coronavirus vaccine trial, they had to pause it.
Right.
They had to pause it earlier this month due to an unexplained illness in a participant, okay? And preparing to restart after investigations concluded that the man, he died of a stroke or something like that. Right. Did not appear to be related to the vaccine, but they didn't know or whatever. I guarantee you, he had a stroke because of that doggone vaccine. I can guarantee that. Right. And if you want me to be a lawyer, I come be a lawyer because I'll tell you why he had a stroke because of them. And then, hold on.
What is the best thing to do to people for it? Eat right.
Yeah,
exercise. I mean, we know we have a train online, child, and I know he can hook up and help you and show you how to eat right and exercise. Eat right, work out. I'm serious. Build your system up.
It still happens to the best of the people.
But you know, when you build your lungs and stuff up like that, and it still kind of helps. It helps your meals. We gotta do that.
Yeah. But whatever, Cassie. So I was tripping when they said Johnson & Johnson. I said, yeah, it got to be not the baby powder people, the cancer. I can't even believe they agreed to that. Just like when I heard that doggone Trump was taking advice from the pillow maker. I said, wait a minute.
Now, yeah.
Right.
What? They're trying to really put people to sleep.
Well, no, he just.
Indefinitely.
No, but see, the thing with him, all he cared about. all this money.
Why?
And he was just, it was his friend that was making a lot of money, and he only made friends with him because he got a lot of money.
Well, that part.
So, he'll listen to anything. Yeah. But, that, and speaking of Trump, and him coming to Michigan,
that part.
I don't like the fact that he came to Michigan because he... He did not stand up. I thought he already came. No, he's coming Tuesday. His kids came. Okay, so his kids came. He already did come to Michigan. Yeah. So I don't like him. Don't come here. You done talked about our big wretch.
That part.
And you're not supporting her. And you didn't have anything to say when those men... were conspiring to kill her, and they got caught.
That part.
You could have at least said something to go against them or something. And to me, that was just very disrespectful. That as a president, as a man in power, as the man in power over the country, that you would not defy them and deny having any affiliation, association, or anything with them to say, you know what, I don't agree with that. I don't agree with all of her. Whatever, everything that she about, but I don't go for that. We don't do that. That's not how we get down.
Exactly.
I mean, he definitely should have stood up and said something. Instead, he just kept talking junk.
You know, he just keep doing what he be doing.
That's foolishness.
He just living his life, and he just happened to get the job.
But when it all boiled down, realistically, this is all about politics, everybody.
It is.
Everybody knows all about politics. You got this president's going to promise you this, and this president's
going to
promise
you that. You got Captain COVID.
You got this,
they call
and you got that.
Look.
So when it all boiled down, God is the one who's the author and finish of everybody's faith. So that's what you're going to have to do.
That is true. You know, Chris Cuomo called him Captain COVID. You know, yes, he's the only one that conquered it so fast. You know what I mean?
No, his son. His son got it Monday. He was killed Tuesday.
Yo, they must got some real syrup over there. I'm talking about because they say he had took a cocktail. I'm like, they don't
cocktail. Was it marijuana?
I don't even know.
What's the stuff?
But what I do know is that Melania been MIA, y'all. I have not seen Caitlyn Jenner on the scene since they got COVID.
Have you? Who's Caitlyn Jenner?
Melania.
Ain't Caitlyn Jenner the Kardashians' dad?
Right, but they look alike now because he want to be he tried to dress like her now. He her now.
Okay, so, why don't you stop playing chess right now, Caitlyn? Now listen, if y'all watch the show, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Google it. I'm about to Google it for y'all. Tired of y'all trying to play me.
There is a picture of them because they had the same outfit.
I'm not even just talking about nobody for real. This is a real. I'm talking.
Smart. I don't know if he was trying to look like her, but it is.
But they helped make him look like her. So when I see Melania, I think of Caitlyn Jenner. So I said, Caitlyn and Donald done caught the COVID and they conquered it, but not Caitlyn that came out. She ain't said nothing.
Praise God. Okay, anyway, y'all, so y'all know.
I'm about to look
that
up if y'all can stop playing.
She's talking about shutting everything back down again.
Well, if they give her power back.
Exactly. You know, but you know, they done did all that. I was supposed to. They done did all that to try to stop her from shutting it down.
It's already on the Google search.
I'm telling you guys. Seriously, I mean, how many times, I'm pretty sure everybody tells you, wear your mask. Now they're talking about, now Fauci is saying that we shouldn't even have Thanksgiving.
Hold on, come here, Daddy. Hold on, y'all. No, I done found a picture. Vera coming to y'all with the picture, y'all. Look at, that's Caitlyn and Melania, y'all. Oh, looking like twins. Look at them. Which one is Caitlyn? Y'all tell me which one y'all think is her. I'm going to tell y'all which one ain't. Now come on back. That was truth right there. I don't be telling no fake news.
The FBI come knock at that door.
I'm gonna be like FBI, Mr. FBI.
She gonna be trying to sue you because I seen that she was trying to sue somebody for a billboard they did.
What? Because they said she looked like Caitlyn Jenner.
No, Ivanka did that. She is too.
Hurry up.
Well, at the end of the day, I don't care. They look alike. It is what it is. You can Google it. Google it. Caitlyn Jenner Melania. As you start putting it in, it come up. Anyway.
But anyway, y'all, you know, we're going to have a show one day where we just let you guys talk. I mean, not let you guys talk because we can't hear y'all.
Well, hold on.
Let you guys talk in and we just have topics on what they want to talk about.
That's true.
Because, you know, you get tired of hearing about the COVID. You get tired of hearing about...
Well, we ain't talking about... Okay,
but right now...
About COVID, another thing about COVID, because Pence got... some of his people got COVID. Five of his closest staff members had COVID, and they mad because
They're still on tour.
Yep, he won't quarantine himself. He's still on tour. They're trying to call him an essential worker. So that's how he's getting a pass to keep on.
So we're going to essentially keep talking about them until this is over. Also, so back to the doggone debate, y'all. Okay. Just in case y'all didn't see it, they were talking about how, you know, Trump and them tried to send the immigrants, the illegal immigrants, back to Mexico, and how they basically separated them from their kids. Oh, yeah. And they had over 500 of the kids still locked up in the cages or whatever that they created.
That was that Thursday debate. What happened Friday?
Oh, Friday. Well, hold on. Let me turn this on Thursday. So Thursday, the debate. So Trump is talking, Biden, him going back and forth. Biden, like, it's 528 kids or whatever it is. That's without their parents in these cages. And then Trump goes, he basically got caught up and was like,
y'all made the cages.
And then he said, well, we're taking good care of them.
It's 500 kids. Oh, what they come out and say? What they say? 500
kids. And then Friday comes.
Friday, he says.
Friday comes to talk to Trump. They talking about the kids that's locked up in the cages. Yes. And this dude gonna say, the parents. I guess they found the parents of the kids.
They found them.
And then he wants their kids.
They want the kids.
Anyway. Oh, okay.
They want the kids.
Okay.
I said, this dude is off the chain.
You're a liar.
I'm not trying to just tell y'all this because I like Trump. I ain't saying that. Because actually, I think he's kind of funny. He's funny to me because I can't take him serious because he's just too ignorant acting. You know what I'm saying? What's up, friend? What's going on? Listen, I see a lot of dudes on here tonight. Check this out. Y'all dudes better tune in on November the 22nd.
Please.
I don't even know why we bought so many men gifts this year for the holiday giveaway. But listen, we did. So men tune in. Yeah. I'll tell you, most likely almost every dude probably gonna get something just because. You know what I'm saying? Because
we got good guy gifts.
Like Ernie, you thought I was hurt.
So back to what I was saying. So Trump said that they found, basically, they done found the parents or whatever, and they don't want their kids anyway.
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah,
come on, man.
Found them the next day after Biden said that you got 500 kids?
I'm going to tell you this. I believe you.
Yeah.
it was national news cases where black men were shot and killed by police officers.
Mm.
And when you were interviewed days after, you said, I have to get back with you because I don't know.
I ain't seen that yet. Yes. He ain't seen the video.
How do you not know the information behind a case that's national in the news right now?
Because I'm not internationally known. But I'm on the microphone.
So let's go, cuz.
And that this is how come, I mean, we listen to stuff and we try to get a little comical about stuff.
Yeah.
But this stuff is serious to people.
It is.
Just like recently, what said in my heart the other day after John and Fetty was on the show.
Oh, yeah.
I think, if I'm not mistaken, a day or two after my first.
I think it was 2 days after that.
This young baby, 3 years old, got shot at Zabaton. You know, people start putting stuff out, and her mother was really offended by it, which is understandable. People, stop putting stuff out that you don't know about.
Right.
We thank God that the baby's okay. Keep lifting her up. Keep lifting her mama. We don't know, you know, to what extent. You know, but keep lifting these people up. This is so important. This is why we have to pray for our city.
Yeah.
I mean, Manson is like this small.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now.
Everybody related.
I mean, everybody know everybody. Manson is this small. Come on.
Yeah.
Nowadays, you mean tell me kids can't go to places like that and have fun? You know, it was a drive-by, but regardless,
why would somebody be shooting up a kid's place?
It's full of kids. The thing on this is that it's sad, you know, and my heart goes out to her mother and the family because that's sad. When we send our kids out to places like that,
I'm dropping my kids off at places like that.
You know, you think that.
Then you can babysit kids like
that. Then your kids to storage. No, I was kidding. But when we take our kids and take them to places like that, we don't expect.
No, you probably don't.
We don't expect
that's a safe place.
That you think that they want to have fun.
Yeah.
You know, can you imagine? And we be praying for that baby because that baby can have an impact of fear of not wanting to go places like that.
Yep.
Even her mother. You know, pray for these families. You know, don't just sit back and say, oh, my God, that was sad. Actually pray for them.
Right.
Because that's something that's going to always stick in a person's head. Yeah. Just like, I don't like it. Like, people talk about COVID. Oh, that's a joke. That's not true.
Absolutely.
We've known people who've had. We thank God for people who've been set free from that. Or who's in the process of being healed from that. This stuff is real, people. And if it's not COVID, it's something.
It's
You can say it's not. But what I'm saying is that let's stop taking serious stuff and playing with it. Because, you know, we can make a change.
Yeah. But see, I think and it's funny that you said that. I think the reason why people don't take stuff serious like that anymore, especially within these last 3 years, people are taking stuff serious because the president don't take nothing serious. Yeah. That dude is a complete joke. I mean, it's like reality TV all day. Yep. All you gotta do is turn on any news channel, period, and they talking about this dude and what he tweeting about and all that. And I know they say fake news, CNN gonna say this, but I'm talking about what he's saying straight out of his own mouth. You know what I'm saying? Like, I watch him as a person. Yep. Like I told y'all before, I judge a person by their character.
Yeah.
And that dude's character is just crazy to me. Like, I know Biden got his flaws. Biden done did some crazy stuff. Yeah. Everybody has. You know what I'm saying?
What have you done?
Name
lately.
What have you done? Okay, anyway, but what I'm saying, everybody done did something crazy in their life. Yeah. And if you haven't praised God, I mean,
you have.
Your time is going to come. I'm
you
sure.
You have.
I'm just saying. I'm
say
like,
you ain't.
I'm like, well, we should. Benefit of the doubt.
We should.
You ain't giving nobody no benefit of the doubt. You don't have to lie.
Don't
have to lie. Everybody
I'm just saying.
Something.
You know, we might have a baby watcher. They ain't did nothing yet. Yeah. But what I'm saying,
got a little high on here.
But what I'm saying though is that it's people out there. You know what I'm saying? That I'm watching him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm watching you as a person, and I hear people say, you know, they both is bad. Yeah. Okay. At the end of the day, that may be so.
True.
But think about everything that you're doing in your life as far as how you on the internet.
Yeah.
You watching TV. You going to the store when you want. You going, your kids going over here to school. Everything that we doing is because somebody voted. And I'm saying this because I know people that don't want to vote because they feel like their vote don't matter. It ain't up to us. They're going to put whoever they want in there or whatever the case may be. And then they want to say they ain't going to vote because they both evil whatever. Biden and Trump got their problems and I ain't going to pick the best. At the end of the day, somebody had to vote for you to be able to even be on here right now.
Yep.
Like, we on Facebook. They can't do this everywhere you live at. Like, in these countries, they got dictatorships and all that. Yep. Do you know when COVID hit? This is what I heard. I'm not for sure if it's all the way true, but I'm going to tell y'all what I heard. If you want to look it up, go ahead. Be my guest.
Google.
Okay? But they said China, when it hit, they shut their internet down.
Yeah.
They did not even want the people telling people what they were doing over there. And they said they would not let their people get on the internet. They was taking them food. They wouldn't let them go to the store to get their groceries.
Then they was sealing them up. They was sealing them. They welded their doors where they can't come out. Right. And then it said one of them, when they finally got the door, the whole family was there.
Yep. See? Yeah, and people and what happened was the reason why they turned the internet off is because somebody had put on YouTube one of the families was that they were starving basically.
Yeah.
And they were saying they didn't have no food because the government was passing out food.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, think about stuff like this. Yeah. Like our United States, free America, whatever.
Yeah.
Somebody voted for us to be able to do all the stuff we're doing. For us to be able to be on YouTube, Facebook, whatever, go to the store, your kid got school of choice. That was a vote.
Yeah.
They voted for that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
It's still states that don't allow that.
Yeah, it's still states, and they're still trying to get school of choice out of there. Like, it's still stuff like that going on. Mm-hmm. So when I hear people say votes don't matter, don't count, it do matter. It don't matter if you safe or not. It matters. Because at the end of the day, even if the Bible tells you to pray for your leader, you still got to pray for whoever wins.
Yeah.
So it may not be the person that you like, but you still got to pray for him. So why not go let your voice be heard for at least go for the person who you know character speaks better of the next person.
Yeah.
So that when you pray, hopefully God can get through to that person easier because their heart is not as hardened.
Yeah, but exactly. You got to look at it like this too. God may tell some people don't vote, period.
That too.
So if somebody come to me and say, well, God told me don't vote.
Now, God tell you not to vote.
I'm not going to judge you because that's your relationship. One thing I never do, if somebody came to me and said, well, God told me this.
Yeah.
Then I'd be like, oh, okay.
But usually, I've never heard anybody say, God told me not to vote.
Right.
It's always somebody that say, I don't get into that.
Well, there's a bunch of people in America you ain't met.
Well, I know that.
Well, I'm
just saying.
I've never. never seen in the Bible where it tells you not to vote. But I see it in the Bible where it says pray. It tells you to abide by the laws of the land. And it tells you.
It tells you to pay your taxes.
And it tells you to pray for your people of authority. Yeah. So what I'm saying is that at the end of the day, let's look at character.
Yeah.
Okay? So let's find out who's got a little bit more sense and won't put us in this mess. I feel like, okay, at some point, if you believe everything the Bible says, some stuff is going to happen regardless, okay?
Right.
Because the end times is coming, okay? That's if you believe the word of God. And I feel like something's going to happen regardless. Hi, Miss D, we love you. And Tracy Carter, we love you too. Oh, okay. I feel like, you know, at the end of the day, when you see certain things going on, okay?
What the Bible say you're known by the fruit that they
You'll know them.
You would know people by
I'm
the
not
fruit.
Saying
that's period.
Exactly. So I'm not saying that you gotta judge a person. Because I mean it's not necessarily your place to put judgment on them. But God do tell you to judge a person by their character. As far as God even tell you this. If the person is too ignorant acting, don't even be around them.
Yeah, that's why he said judge by fruit. He tells you if you
read
the book of Proverbs. The book of Proverbs basically tell you a lot about.
I'm telling you,
people's character, type of people that you do and don't want to associate yourself with.
That part,
you know, the Bible said a lie when you tear into the kingdom. So I wonder if Trump tearing into the kingdom.
That boy be lying.
I mean, I'm just saying. That you know what you're doing.
We ain't gonna tell you no more. That's
between you and God. You know, but what I'm saying is this and that.
I'm just telling you that I ain't voting for Trump.
Voting for Trump. All I'm gonna say is know your opponent. Okay, yeah. So I'm gonna say like this: no, vote for the person who stands for, like I said before, stand for what you stand for.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna tell you like this: we're gonna take the names off of the person. Yeah. Say you got a ministry.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, that's what you're about to say.
I was listening to a message today on that from Pastor Mark Baller.
Say you got a ministry and you got some people in your in the person in your church come, and every time he come to church, he dogging all the women.
He's not talking about like this last.
But listen though, he come to your church, he want to dog every woman that got a position because he don't think they should be up there.
Yeah.
And then he cussing everybody out. And then he lying.
Wait, the pastor?
Yep. No, not the pastor. Just the minister. No, just somebody that's going to your church.
Okay.
I said, look, this is the scenario.
Okay.
Say y'all got a church.
Okay.
And
it's a member there.
It's a member. Yeah. It's a member that go there.
Okay.
And matter of fact, I'll put him in position. He got a position. Okay.
Give him a position.
He got a position. He a deacon.
The deacon.
He a deacon in the church.
Oh.
And he comes in and he dogs every woman with the gifts and the talent that's up there, you know, ministering. Because he feel like a woman should shut up. And go sit down and do like she told, okay?
I talk too much.
You see what I'm saying? And then the offering book comes along. And he say, oh, thank you. You give your offering, I'm going to keep mine. Because I don't have to do that. That's up to you. If you want to give yours, I ain't got to give mine because God gave me a choice. And he keep on going. Now, that's Trump. And then he said, come around. Trump don't pay his taxes. The taxes is the offering book. Okay,
that's a very good example, Latoya.
I'm just saying, you got all these Christians out here who want to be vulnerable. I'm just saying, look at Trump. And just saying, if he don't pay his taxes, he ain't paying his tithes. I'm just saying. That's all I'm saying. Now, it made sense to me. I'll put some stuff together on y'all. I'm just saying, y'all ask me.
And you did.
I'm going to figure it out.
But see, that's why I was going to run for president. You know what? If Kanye West can do it, I can do it.
What?
For real, I'm doing it.
Mom.
What?
It's Kanye, okay?
Oh, like Cayenne Pepper?
No, it's Kanye, like Kanye. Like Von Sway. Kanye.
Okay, even which way it go, if he can run for president, I'm going to do it. You know what? I'm going to do it for real.
Nanny.
I'm going to do it because I feel like this. I mean, you really don't have credentials. You don't have they're really making it look like you don't have to have credentials. Because that's why they put up Head of State. That movie Head of State.
Head of State.
They put that up there.
Head of State.
Yeah. Uh-huh. They put that there. Then next thing you know, they brought in Trump.
They
he didn't have no knowledge of politics at all. I've got no knowledge of Trump, what I mean.
You know, I want to be Biden's. I want to run
the VP.
Yeah,
like you come and slap me
like Head of State,
like Bernie Mac did.
Yep, I just come and slap.
But no, but for real, if you, going back to the debate, what was you just saying, Didi?
I'm just talking about seriously as far as they just put anybody in office.
That part.
And so, they are.
Going back to the debate, because, you know, Trump always get on TV, he always get up and say that he's running and he's doing it because of what Trump, Obama and Biden is what made him run.
Yeah, he said that.
Right? Yeah. And he act like, it's your fault I'm running because y'all couldn't, you whatever, whatever, whatever. Like they lost. Like, they served as many terms as they could serve. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Obama, they maxed out.
Yeah, Obama, if he ran again, I'll vote for him again. And he, like I told y'all before, he throw away the rights. If he become a dictator, I keep Obama in there.
But you know what? That was like with anything. When you was talking about judge people by the fruit, like I listened to a message today. Praise God. I thank God for advancing God's kingdom.
Amen. Oh, yeah. And, amen. And praise God.
And he was saying that how you really have to watch, in other words, the company that you keep, the people that you're around. Mm-hmm. If you're around somebody that's always talking negative and stuff like that,
yes.
You know, because I'm telling you something, when I'm mad, I want somebody around me who's going to, maybe not at that time, because I'm real mad, to give me some wisdom, something that's help going to Lord. Help me out. She yeah, but what I'm saying that, I don't want to be around nobody that's always that's negative all the time. Because that's draining.
It is.
People will drain you. And I mean to the point where you find yourself, you be so weak, you be like, man, I'm tired. What am I talking about? I ain't do nothing to talk to so-and-so on the phone. Well, that's what happened. What was they doing?
Yeah.
Don't let just people just deposit anything. That's what he was saying.
Yeah.
Watch what you, even the Bible tells you that, to watch what you take and guard your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Our heart is like a computer. Let's say you have a computer right here. You have a monitor. Let's say sometimes you need to upgrade yourself.
Mm.
So when you start seeing yourself with looking like it's all straggling, you need to upgrade the computer.
Right.
Well, sometimes you learn from your old computer. You start seeing like, you know what? My old computer kept getting viruses and all of that.
Yeah.
You know, when I get my new computer, I'm not gonna be doing. I'm not gonna put that information on there because I see
exactly.
Every time I put this on there,
I get a virus.
I kept getting the virus.
Oh.
My new computer, I will not do that with my new computer.
Yeah, you're not gonna do that. And you know, we start getting to a certain level in Christ. Well, God, if you get to a certain level in Christ, you should want to anyway start surrounding yourself around more a positive attitude.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, because I'm like this. Yeah. If I'm going through something and you're going through something, we're going to have to find somebody who ain't going through nothing.
Yeah.
Who can give me some, words.
Or at least know how to go through it.
Know how to pull me through it.
Yeah, who's basically coming out of it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's why if you're going through something, everybody can't necessarily know about your situation.
And you don't always tell. That's another thing. You can't tell everybody your business.
I said it.
You can't. You be thinking, oh, girl, they saved, sanctified, they spoke
everybody
it. They spoke it one tongue. So I'm going to tell them my business, girl.
They spoke it one tongue.
You spoke it one tongue. You said, El Shaddai. What did say the French word?
Oh, shut up.
Shut up. That's all you said. Now, since I tell you my whole life story.
All your business.
Yeah. So you know what I'm saying? You can't
do that.
Just because people say, because some people, they even though they say, if you ain't saved like that, what makes you think everybody else is saved like that?
Right. What makes you think that?
Because people can, they'll be okay and try to act like they, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And they're not for you.
And then after they done talking to you, like, girl, you
ought to
know.
Girl, she thinks she's so saved, girl. Yeah. I want to be with her because she had on some stockings today, girl, and they had holes in them, girl.
Girl, she going through.
Hey, my friend.
Girl, they going through. She got, girl, her bills. She ain't got no money to pay her bills.
Mm. Yeah.
She about to lose her job. They about to lose their house. I mean, you know, you confiding in somebody and telling them something, thinking they could have just prayed for you, even. They prayed for you.
And you got to watch out who you let pray for you.
And see, I'm saying.
Because everybody hearted in the right place when they pray for you. I mean, it just, you got to learn how to have a spirit of discernment.
Because some people don't pray for you. They do like that. And then they done. I'm like, what you just said?
But you can. You gotta guard your heart. You gotta guard everything. You gotta make sure you gotta make sure that your mind is in a place where you're not just telling people your business because you're hurting.
Thank you.
But you do need to make sure you find somebody that you can talk to when you're hurting. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Or when you are in need. You know, you should know somebody that can. If you don't know nobody, that's why you need to be in church. Because you need to go get you a good church.
Yes.
Find a good church.
Right now, it might be hard to get in a church. But that's why you have a few key people that you fellowship and have a relationship with. Yeah. But you can't. Everybody can't know your business.
Everybody cannot know your business.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just real talk.
Because some people will kill your, I always say this, let's say it's your business is your seed to a certain degree.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Now let's say you have a seed that you want to start a business per se.
Yeah.
Okay. Now this is just me messing up another scenario, y'all.
Don't make up a scenario. Tell them we started our business.
But not
when
the scenario. Business,
we didn't tell nobody.
You can't tell everybody everything. Yeah. So you don't tell them where you're gonna be moving to. Yeah. You can't tell them what you're trying to come up with and do.
Yeah.
None of that. Like because you have people that pray against you.
Yeah.
You have
or just making comments.
Yeah.
Because idle words have power.
Yeah.
Idle words plant seeds or water negative seeds.
Yes.
You gotta know who to talk to when you want to rejoice. Because you could be trying to tell somebody something because you're happy about it.
Yep.
You know, it's good to have friends who know how to cheer for you without being jealous of
it. It is.
What I'm saying? And people that's going to cheer for you because they really are genuinely happy for you and want to see you win for real.
Yeah.
You know, but instead you have people that's low-key cheering, but in the same sense, it'd be an old ugly cheer.
Oh.
This is what I mean by ugly.
What's an ugly chair, girl? I need an ugly chair. Let's say you come to me, I'm happy. I'm coming to you happy. Girl, your grandma could die me a hoe.
Ooh.
Ah! I'm excited.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay. That hurt that
girl. Girl,
I'm excited. That's the ugly chair.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But come to me and say it again.
Grandma to get me a
hoe. Ah! Where we moving to?
Girl, we moving.
We moving.
Where? I ain't tell you so.
See, that was it. But that's how you do a happy chair.
I ain't
saying this movie. We're trying to teach y'all how not to be
to
hurt.
With your friend.
And to reject, exactly. Teach y'all how to be out here because, you know, sometimes when you let your guard down, because, you know, for the most part, like for me, I'm a good person. So yeah, I be trying to make, I want to make everybody be a good person. Like, you know what I'm saying? And so,
I'm going to make you be a good person.
She want to make you. She want to create you.
I want you to be a good person. She so, like, everybody, like me and Chanel was talking about when she was on here. You can be in our family if you cool. Like,
my cousin.
Or whatever. Like, that's just how I am. Yeah. But there's some people who will take that and be a snake behind your back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And they really ain't for you, you know? And one day we're going to have an episode about this, y'all, because I know there's a lot of people out there who know us, but y'all don't really know everything about us. You know what I'm saying? And people done did some dirty stuff to me. Some dirty stuff.
That
you know what I'm saying?
True.
That I ain't never, ever spoke on. And I think I might speak on it. Mm. I ain't going to say no names of who did it, but I think I might speak on it only to help somebody else because I had to learn to just go ahead and give it to God and not retaliate.
She did.
Because
she really did. Because she,
God's still
we're
working
about
on
to be Bonnie Clyde up in here.
Even though it was her situation, God's still working on me.
Amen.
You know, her situation.
Really, I mean, for real, because sometimes, you know, your heart is right and you whatever, you let your guards down. And I'm not telling somebody, in the Bible said in the last day, people going to harden their hearts, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I don't want you to harden your heart to a place where you can't let nobody in.
That's true.
But I need people just to be a little bit more, you know, protective of their hearts. And especially at a time like this, when people are the most vulnerable. Watch them pray. Right now, people are vulnerable. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they are.
People are hurting.
Yeah.
People are alone. People are, you know, are sick. They shut in.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just a lot going on for people. And they're going through, and then they don't have people to talk to about stuff. And so it's snakes out there who want to act like they're your friend
that
just so they can know your business
that
and dog
true.
You on the back end.
That is true.
And so we might have to have an episode about that. I'm going to figure out who I can get on here to be a guest so we can talk some stuff. Talk some smack about some stuff. You know, I still give y'all a little bit of wisdom on the side.
Stay saved
in the process.
I might not be able to be on the episode.
God's
still working on me.
And then, just to let y'all know, we're going to be coming up. We got a worship episode coming up.
Amen.
It's going to be called our Let Go and Let God
episode.
Come on. We're going to come on here and we're going to have people be an encouragement to each other.
Yes.
You know, we're going to Pastor Baldwin is going to come and be a guest for us.
Yes.
She's going to come on home. And it, next week, now I'm going to go ahead and tell Vera business right now. She may not want me to, but I'm going to tell part of it.
No, let her tell it. How do you want to tell somebody else?
Hey, I ain't going to tell her testimony.
She can tell it. Then she can see if she's a good friend.
So next week. Next week, we won't be having a guest, though. Hi, Dara, girl. We love you. We won't be having a guest next week. Y'all know every other week we have a guest. We're not going to have a guest next week because Vera, y'all, is moving.
God bless her with our house.
So we moving, y'all. And so, at the end of the day, we
are Bernie.
Well, she's pregnant.
No. We're going to be moving, y'all. So Vera's going to be moving, so we won't have a guest on next week. We still will be having a show. But on November the 8th, I want y'all to write this down.
November the 8th,
please join us for an unforgettable worship service episode.
Yes.
Let go and let God. It's going to be very good.
I'm trying to tell you,
Sister Sabrina is going to be playing on the keys. And anybody that knows Sabrina Todd,
she'll be hitting them keys.
If she hit them keys, y'all.
Tell us to put them down for the dance.
When she hit them keys, the anointing is automatically for certain keys that just make the spirit
put
comes.
You in the atmosphere.
They hating y'all because guess what? They didn't even ask me to do it. But that's okay because me and my friend going to run this table right here.
And Mama and Pastor Baldwin will be the host, y'all. It's going to be amazing. Y'all, please join us November the 8th. It's on here live at 7 p.m. like we always do from 7 to 8. So, y'all, we want to say thank y'all once again for sticking with us on today. We hope that we can give y'all some information that will help, you know, guide y'all or encourage y'all to look some stuff up. Go out there and vote. If you need to know, you go to iwillvote.com/MI to know where your early voting polls are at.
For real.
We're going to be voting early. I need people to make sure y'all go get y'all voice.
And be safe.
Be safe.
Yeah.
And don't forget, November.